Agony, is it, Rich?
Oh, no, Sarge. Turd just catches me now and again.
Only a prize Wally were dirting himself on a SHIELD training course.
Yeah, well, if I wanted to do PT, I'd have joined the SAS, wouldn't I?
Yeah, he who dares ricks his back.
Very useful thing, that, Rich.
Yeah, for a fit man.
Sandhill Police Station, good morning.
Oh, hello, yes. This is Roger Philpott, City Farm.
Yes, Mr. Philpott. Well,
sorry to bother you, but we've had a break-in. A couple of our pigs are missing.
Right, would you just like to hold on a moment, sir? Sarge?
Yeah?
Two of our pigs are missing.
What?
It's a city farm. They've had a breakout.
I think they've got the wrong pig. Hello, with you as soon as possible, Tapper, raising assistance.
Yeah, well, what's the bloody holdup?
Transport.
The bloody pig?
That's right.
Well, why can't the guy from the farm pick it up?
Well, apparently he's only got a mini.
Well, the Sherpa's loaded up, Sarge.
Get it unloaded.
Well, hurry up, this Tappy's got its cornered.
I'll get Jimmy Carver to meet you at Pound Place. Get Jimmy for me, will you? All right? He's good with kids. He's probably good with animals.
Yeah, well, if it shits all over the van, I'm not cleaning it out.
Yes, you are.
Over.
Rather them than me, Sarge. Pigs bite, you know.
Excuse me. Oh, hello. Roger Philpott from the farm.
Oh,
which one have you got? Oh, it's Blanc. No sign of Pickle, I suppose.
Having fun, Taff?
About bloody time.
Go on, Jimbo, get in there. Piggy!
Pig! Careful, please. Pig's a very sensitive to stress.
All right, mate.
Pig, pig, pig. You haven't seen another one on your travels, have you?
Eh?
This one's plump. Pickle's still at large.
No sweat, we'll put out an all unit. What's its reg number?
Piggy! Steady!
Go on, you great girls, blouse. Here, how are we going to get it in a bleeding van?
I'll not use that door as a ramble, Sammy.
Clever, Dick.
Got him!
If you could just keep him in the corner. I don't... Oh, hold it. Hold it now. Hold it. In you go, love, get him out.
Come on out. You got hose, love? There you go, Taff, get the hose.
Come on, mate, you're the driver.
What are you talking about before you was brought up on a farm?
Yeah. Well, bullies, not English pigs.
Right.
Mr. Philpott? Mr. Philpott?
You've really thrown my eggs in this morning.
Look, we haven't yet established...
Here, hold these for me, would you?
Mr. Philpott, we haven't yet established how the pigs escaped.
They didn't escape. Somebody let them out.
Oh, yeah?
Oh. Come and look. The sty door had been opened, and, well, pigs don't use wire cutters. We're lucky we only lost Plonk and Pickle.
So it was vandals, was it?
Animal Life League, I think. Well, we've had a few letters lately. Meat is murder, that kind of thing. You're not a vegetarian, are you?
Oh, no, I'm Welsh, I eat anything.
Quite right. Pragmatism's the only sane approach.
Yes, Mr. Philpott, you haven't still got them, have you, the letters?
Oh, no.
Well, then we haven't got much else to go on, I'm afraid. Of course, we'll do the best we can.
And that's it, is it?
Well, I'm sorry, sir.
Well, a Pickle's still missing, you know. Well, you may not think it's serious, but she's a very important member of our community.
No, it's not a question of what I think, sir. As I say, we'll do the best we can.
Well, thanks, then. Sorry to have been a nuisance.
You finished yet, Muzz?
Golly, no! Oops.
Well done, then.
No, mate, you missed the top half.
We'll lift back to your feet.
Oh, thanks very much. You might at least say sorry.
Good stuff, that makes your toes curl. How'd they get out then?
The nutty blue kid cut a hole in the fence. At least that's what he reckons. Anyway, there's enough all to go on.
Right, he's had his 20 minutes in, on to the next. You coming or what? Where do you want to drop it off?
Larry's. I could do with a cup of tea.
Ooh, stick your feet outside, can't you?
What is that, Larry?
Where have you been,
doing?
Less than a pig, as it happens.
Never, not you, Taff. Not before breakfast. Full breakfast for Taff.
No, Larry, I'll just have a cup of tea.
Then I get back out on the street. Eh?
No breakfast?
No crap.
No breakfast for Taff.
Here, you haven't got a runaway pig on the premises, have you?
A runaway pig, huh? Yeah. Plenty dead flies.
This Posh Overton thing's getting silly. I've gone 2 months now with bugger all.
Hey, up, it's Bruce Lee.
Yeah, you'll see when you go on it. It'll cripple half the force.
Overtime's not on right, though.
Yeah, well, right or not, I've had a cut in wages. A big cut.
Full breakfast, please, having a cup of tea.
Cheer up, Muss. Money into everything, you know.
True. There is sex.
True, is there? Cup of tea and a bacon sandwich, please, love.
Now, well, sure, looks like Taffy can afford to ponce around all day. Some of us have got commitments. What we really need is another good murder.
Well, do us a favour, will you?
It's true. And if there was one, you'd be in there copping like the rest of us. So would Jimbo.
Aye?
Trouble is, there's too many hypocrites in this job.
No one could say that about you, Pete.
This is true. You must always cause a spade a spade.
Yeah.
Anyway, you must have made a bum out of miners' strike. I spent more time in Yorkshire than I have.
Yeah, but bloody Scargill gave up too soon, didn't he? My American holiday was only half paid for.
Well, you shouldn't have blown most of it on a new bike then, should you?
Didn't you put some away for the taxman?
Taxman? What are you talking about?
Your picket money.
He's had his share. Well, pay as you earn, you prat, or don't they tax beads and mirrors?
We're only taxed at the basic rate. If you earn over the limit, they claw it back. Later.
He's winding me up. Here, Sarge.
Yes, Muswell.
You know our money from the miners' strike?
How could I ever forget?
We paid the tax on it, haven't we?
Yeah. Apart from super grabbers like you. No. Oh.
10. When Inspector Galloway comes in, can you ask him to have a rethink on this expenses claim? There's no way I can pass that, I'm afraid.
Henry, have you read this lot of old bullshit? The recently imposed overtime restrictions will not reduce our operational effectiveness. Although paperwork may get held up, we must all endeavour to be as efficient as possible in the issue of reports to whichever department.
I drafted it.
Yeah, well, paperwork's the only bloody thing that doesn't get held up around here.
Perhaps if your CID brethren were to clock in promptly, there'd be less need for overtime.
Dash was out on a job.
Well, he's not booked out on the duty state. All in.
Pedantic little twat.
Oh, dear.
CID, DS Roach.
Morning. Can I speak to Roy Galloway, please?
He's not here at the moment. Can I help?
Barry Blades, immigration.
Sorry, mate. Barry Blades what?
Immigration.
Just a minute. Barry Blades, immigration.
Sorry. Hello, Barry. Roy, sorry I didn't get back to you yesterday.
That's OK. It all fixed up.
Yeah, no problem. What time are you going to be out? Past 11, yeah?
Yeah.
OK, well, just see the duty sergeant if I'm not around, OK?
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
Immigration, what do they want?
Deporting all the Irish in your first
home. Oh, very droll.
What's this? Operational overtime? Where's Mike?
The con artist with the wardrobe. He's checking up on a list of people who knew Miss Clark and who had a key to the flat.
Well, hasn't he done that yet?
Well, he was told he couldn't do overtime yesterday. We both were.
Who by?
Who do you think? You weren't here at the time.
Bloody ridiculous. What are you up to today, then?
Pursuing inquiries on the credit card job.
Any danger of an arrest?
Not imminent, no.
Well, you want to watch it. Chief Sewer might take off that case as well.
Well, depending on whether I can get a description confirmed this morning. I wanted to see the girl last night, but...
Right. I'm supposed to be briefing a divisional planning meeting. And then, I'm off to Bethnal Green, Nick. So I'll see you later, all right?
That's another thing that doesn't get held up. Planning. It's all planning and bloody paperwork.
Well, don't tell me, mate. Tell that lot at the Dream Factory, all right?
Oh, by the way, Happy Henry has turned up. This didn't get past the censor, I'm afraid.
What's the matter? Didn't I claim enough?
A black market in carbon paper here, or what? I never find a scrap when I want a bit.
Ah, right, sir. Yes, that's fine. We'll bring you a plan,
Right. Would you just like to sign here, then?
Yeah, but what about the rest?
The other stuff's still the subject of inquiries, I'm afraid.
Yeah, but it wasn't stolen.
Well, as soon as the title's been cleared, we'll notify you.
And how long would that be?
I'm sorry, I really can't say. We won't hold it any longer than we need to.
Oh, like hell. The next time I come, you'll go
Reg, together. Reg, if you're going to walk around all day with that bit of paper in your hand, could you change it now and again?
Yeah, so,
up your lawn.
I heard a rumour that Emmy Talbot's thinking of retiring.
Yeah, that's right. We're holding a piss up for him in a telephone kiosk.
Yeah, well, how do you see me? I was sort of wondering, is the next chief superintendent's clerk?
I can honestly say, Reg, I can't think of anyone more suitable at Sunhill.
Oh, thanks, Archie.
The only problem is, it's not a job for an able-bodied copper.
Ah, no, well, exactly, yeah. I mean, I'm not one to complain, right? But, I was wondering, what about if my back's been permanently damaged?
Match your brain, then, won't it? Mm. Thanks, Nick.
My pleasure, darling. I'll get some breakfast myself.
OK,
now.
Then.
There you go.
Sunny
Old
Police Station, good morning.
Morning, Bob.
Hello, Roy.
I forgot to tell you yesterday, Barry Blades Immigration wants to borrow three or less today.
Blades? Oh,
yeah,
no.
But it won't take long. He's doing a sweatshop down in Caffrey Street. I told him there'd be no problem.
Well, you should have told him we're here to nick villains, not some poor sod who's been born in the wrong country.
Or you can tell him yourself, we'll be here at 11:30. All right.
No, it ain't all right. Doing their dirty bloody work for them.
Oh, right, right. What is that? Oh, right. Did you read my memo?
Memo, sir?
Operational overtime. It should have been in your truck.
Oh, yes, sir. That one.
Oh, good. We'll have a talk about it later on, when Talbot's collated the overtime figures.
Yes, sir. If I can find the time.
We'll make time, shall we, Roy?
Yes, sir.
Right. Morning. Morning. Hello, Horace. You back with us?
Yes, sir.
Did you enjoy the course?
I wanted you to spend a few minutes just to talk about...
Good morning.
Manager, all right, Grandy?
Right, Mr. Lowe, we'll have somebody there as quickly as possible. Can you just give me the address
again?
Can you
stop that van out before you disappear to your tax agent?
Where were those other signs in
there? That's 17, is it, sir?
That's right, yes. It's ruining my business. Yeah. People can't get into my
shop. Okay, then, so
well, thanks
very
much. They've been the same place, haven't they?
Yeah, right,
surprise.
Sarge, yeah? Disturbance at the first shop in Masson Row. I think they're animal life demonstrators.
Where?
Masson Row, 3B. Taffy, Sarge.
Oh, you won't raise him. You don't come out of Larry's till 10.
How many of them?
Three in the shop, few outside, mostly women.
I can't get down there.
I'll go. Can I have your pocketbook, Sarge?
Hang on. Yeah. Call up June. She should be pretty adjacent. You get down there in the van and you go with them.
Hey?
Be careful how you handle it.
Handle what, Sarge?
Nutters for wildlife, Dave, you know.
Are you receiving me? Over.
Is it?
Why not?
You're
going to die trying to take the Queen's.
What?
101-0-1-1-0-1
from Sierra Oscar,
are you receiving me? Yeah, loud and clear, Viv. Sarge, Taffy.
That's fine. Just... Back in circulation, then, are we,
Taffy? Sorry, Sarge? Some of your mates are dealing with an incident on your ground. I wondered if you could get along there and give them a hand.
Yeah, where, Sarge?
The fur shop in Masson Row. You remember Masson Row, don't you? Now proceed there, and I'll speak to you later.
Masson Row?
That's right. But don't give yourself indigestion. Over and out.
Poor old tap.
Poor old tap, my arse.
Can I have a look at what you're handing out, please, madam? What are you trying to give it?
I know, I just want to...
Excuse me. Excuse me, please. Oh, it's hardly South Yorkshire, is it?
Better than nothing, I suppose.
Look, I'll handle this. Excuse me, lads.
I don't want to read your damn leaflet.
Mr. Lowe.
Oh.
About? Do you want these persons on your premises, sir?
Oh, yes, they're very good for custom, very good for my business. Of course I don't.
I shall assist you to remove them. Come on, miss.
Look, we're only trying to put a point of view, for God's sake. Why do you have to come in here?
Do you mind putting it outside?
Yes, we do mind.
Now look, ladies.
You patronise us, you pig. Fur traders out! 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 Fur traders out!
Right, either you leave under your own steam or you get carried out.
Fur traders out! Fur trade is out!
No conservation! There will be no fur trade!
Fur trade is out! Fur trade is out! Fur trade is out!
Look, ladies, calm it. Anyone who tries to get back in gets nicked for breach of the peace.
Fur trade is out!
Fur trade is out!
Right, enough!
Fur trade is out! Fur trade is out!
Fur trade is out!
Bastards!
Fur trade
is out! Let's do it again, no matter how many times you luck.
Yeah, no doubt. Fur trade is out! Better like the never trappy!
Fur trade is out!
Come on!
Out! Get off ya, buses! Pig!
Out!
Get off ya, buses!
Fur trade is out!
Your time, didn't you, chap? I only just got the bloody call.
Oh, yeah, no point calling you while you was in Larry's, was there?
I wasn't in Larry's.
Breaking out of the lights on.
I bloody wasn't. Look, I've been pounding the biggest pigshit on me trousers for the last 2 bloody hours because of you. Have you been dropping me in it with Clio? I'm bloody talking to you.
I don't need to, mate. He already knows you're a lazy pig.
On the beach. Look, if you want witnesses, you can ask anybody.
All right.
Who was in the cafe.
All right. I'm not going to call you a liar. We should have called you up straight away. But I am not blind and I am not stupid. Now, you do disappear sometimes. Don't you?
Occasionally, maybe, Sarge.
Are you getting fed up with the job?
No, Sarge.
Well, then start pulling your weight again, right? What are you doing here now? I thought your break was at 9.
I thought maybe I ought to change my trousers. They stink.
Oh, yeah. Frighten you that much, do I? Go on, away you go. But let's give Larry's a miss for a while, shall we?
Yes, Sarge.
Right. Where's the charge sheets? All this was supposed to be...
Charge sheets? Cabinet, Sarge.
Right, what happened? Constable Carver?
Well, 10 o'clock this morning, I know other officers here present were called to Premier Furs, a clothing shop on Masson Row.
The big brave boys...
Sitting on the floor in the shop were 3 persons, and the proprietor, Mr. Lowe, confirmed were unwanted on the premises. We therefore assisted him to eject them.
Shut up!
The prisoners were arrested when attempting to forcibly re-enter the shop, such an attempt amounting, in my opinion, to threatening behaviour likely to cause a breach of the peace, Sergeant.
Breach of the peace? There was no breach of the peace till you lot barged in. You heard what the officer said? Anything sensible you want to add to that?
Yeah. You're all a lot of bastards.
Fine. What about you?
Only that we'll do it again and again until the murder stops.
Well, in that case, I'm afraid we're going to have to look after your property while you stay with us. Do you mind turning out your pockets, please? Could you turn out your pockets?
No, I couldn't.
Acton, take this lady down to one of the cells and search her, will you? Might as well take the other two down and get Martella to command.
Sarge? You're 41. Yeah, it's not an easy job, you know. No, it'll be a chief super's clerk you have to be.
Petty. Bloody-minded.
Sneaky.
Now, able to handle responsibility, you got to take the load off the chief super, advise him, know all the rules and regs.
Is that so?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. A good super's clerk is indispensable. It's definitely a job for life.
Well, you better apply then, Reg.
Yeah.
I always thought you should be put away.
Fifth. You wanted in the cells? Body search.
Oh, you take over here for me, please, Nick.
I'll do a body search for you if you want.
Now, I wouldn't if I was you, mate. You can catch all kinds of stuff now, don't you?
The rest will have to come off too, I'm afraid.
And you better take them off then, hadn't Do you enjoy degrading your fellow women?
It's been reported by a Mrs. Lambert, sir. The address is
13 The Hollies, Midgley Walk.
Why are you telling me all this, son? Get hold of DC Dashwood.
Well, I thought, sir, or Sergeant Roach, that the area care centre was definitely a job for CID.
Any mention of a wardrobe, was there?
A wardrobe, sir?
Yeah, you know what a wardrobe is, don't you?
Yes, sir, but, no, there's no mention, sir.
All right, I'll look in.
A wardrobe?
The time we spend on these loonies are more grief than bank robbers.
You had to put up with that row, Sarge.
Till the court tomorrow, we do, yeah. No way I could give them bail. I mean, if I was Jimmy Carver, I'd think about charging one of them with assault.
Morning, Sergeant Cryer.
Morning, Mr. Blades.
Roy Galloway said you'd be expecting me.
Yeah, you want a couple of bods for Caffrey Street, right?
If that's okay.
Well, it isn't, but still. They're upstairs in the canteen at the moment, enjoying a well-earned cup of tea. Just about to join them. Nick, get on to Abe Littleton. Tell him to be at the corner of Commercial and Caffrey Street in about 15 minutes. He knows what it's about.
Alright.
Well, I hope you're not going to be too lucky today. We've got a full house as it is.
So I can hear.
Two teas, please, love.
I'll get these.
Oh, cheers. Now, you're right, pain your lot. I've got to take men off real police work for this, and I'm stretched enough as it is.
That's a piece of piss. Either of you been on one of these before?
No, sir.
I'm not expecting any aggro. It's only a small place, as you probably know. My colleague, Greg Simpson.
Hello.
Sorry for the delay, Greg. Had a cup of tea forced on me. Right, you'll follow on in the van then, will you?
Yes, sir.
Thanks for the tea. Oh, and on the way, I just want to stick something in the cleaners. Forgot when I came in this morning.
All right, sir. But why do we have to get this bastard job over?
Cheaper to use us, isn't it?
Littleton. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Have all you in on this as well, are you?
Okay. I want one of you at the front, one at the back, and one in with us. That better be yours, you're the beat officer. And remember, I don't want any of you to do anything. You're just here to ensure there isn't a breach of the peace, right?
Back side of front.
Doing the bugs a favour. You'd be better off back in Calcutta. Right, son, gently does it.
Gallagher.
Mr. Dev. My name's Blaze, Mr. Dev. Immigration Department of the Home Office.
Yeah?
I wonder if I could have a chat to some of your employees.
Fewer here than I thought, sir.
Just the iffy ones then, Greg. And straight down the neck.
Kann sie so wann samajhte ho?
Main Hindi baat karta hoon.
Tumra naam kya hai?
Mera naam? Nitin Gupta.
Ain't you got nothing better to do? Leave the poor buggers alone.
It's nothing to do with me.
Tumra naam kya hai?
Mera naam Nitin Nilina Chachaji hai.
Tu smokeman kab aaye?
Tu sahi ek sahi idea hai.
Tumra passport kahan hai?
Yahan.
Gupta.
Yeah.
And Mrs. Chatterjee.
Shukri.
There seem to be more Chatterjees over here than Patels.
Fancy Zuban so much to hold.
Hindi.
Did you shadi to the hall?
Huh?
Uski nationality kya hai?
Hindi.
Right. Hey, Martin.
Idhar aao. Puraya. Tera naam ki hai?
Palermoy.
Can you take kum kar de kina? Chair khayda?
6 mahine.
Malak?
Okay, down a neck. Tell him not to shit himself. We only want to chat in private.
Mere nala.
Hello, down hello.
You proud of yourself, black man?
Six zero zero from 210. Job's finished, Jim.
Thanks for your help, sir. Any time.
Well done, chaps. Another blow against the black economy.
Cheers, then. Maybe see you lads back at the Nick.
All right. Oh, Snowball, how many times have I told you to use a hanky?
What?
You got gobble down your back. Yeah, clean him up and change his loincloth, Jimbo. I've got to make a phone call before we get back to the Nick. There's a box just around the corner, all right?
Hold still a minute. Hold still a minute, Abe. There you go. You fancy a drink after what?
What's this, your community relations bit?
Piss off.
And these men delivering the wardrobe knocked on your door at 9:30, you say, Mrs. Dixon?
Yes, that's right. Two very nice, polite men. Oh, Mrs. Lambert hadn't said she bought a new wardrobe, but she does buy lots of things from Bensham's, and, well, this seems so natural. And I always do let people in for Beryl when she's out. You know, meter readers, television repairs,
so other people know you've got a key to Mrs. Lambert's house?
Well, yes, I suppose some people.
So, you came along here with the men delivering the wardrobe to Mrs. Lambert's house, and you let them in?
Well, they could hardly leave it in the street.
Please, Mrs. Dixon. Nobody's blaming you.
Could we...
Do come in, Inspector.
May England change ne pele ayasi, pamira passport gongayasi. Just those ne ite anda intazam kitasi, usdana emethe. O lester chalagiahe, menun petaneho, kithe rendahe. Kitum coach ho chena chenda hai?
Nay.
At the week.
Right, I'll get his room ready for him.
Fancy cover?
No, I've got to make a phone call, mate.
Another one? So what's going on, Muzz?
Starting something up.
Oh, yeah, like what?
Never you mind, private.
Well, I'm not going to ask if you're not going to tell.
Just a way of earning a bit extra now. The bloody overtime's up the spell, that's all.
Do what? A part-time job moonlighting, you mean? All right, arsehole, what's his marvellous job then, eh?
Looking after Rich Harris. All the old oil shakes and whatnot, we covered us the London for holiday after Ramadan.
What, you're going to be a minder?
What are you two still doing here? Ladies and gentlemen, I got back hours ago.
Call the traffic, Sarge.
Come on here.
Got some writing up to do, Sarge. Well, you told me this morning at parade to keep up to date.
Right. You know, we normally nick blokes for loitering in these places.
Still soaking, are we, Tef?
No.
Well, it's a bit iffy, isn't it?
What?
What is Arab lark?
It's a doddle. Are we doing nice? Just making sure them and their tarts aren't disturbed in their hotel rooms.
So how much do you get?
50 quid a night, cash in it. I need that money, Jimbo. Put the word for you, shall I?
No, thanks, Mas.
How about you, Tef?
What?
2 weeks of that, 500 quid.
Tax man taken care of. Couple more later on, already paid for.
What about your shifts?
It fits, doesn't it? I've got to start on the 3rd or I don't get the job. I'm on late's that week, early's the next.
Magic.
All I've got to do is bring lunchtime and confirm.
I always stay when I let people in for Beryl. I mean, otherwise they might...
It's just knowing that somebody's been in here.
I'd be grateful if you didn't touch anything, Mrs. Lamb, until our scenes of crime officers had a chance to have a look over things. All right. Mrs. Dixon, did they get you to sign a delivery note or anything like that?
Yes, yes, they did.
Now, the letterhead, did you notice any name or anything that was printed on it?
No, I'm afraid I didn't. They said they were from Bensham's. They delivered a wardrobe. They were only here for a few minutes. I had no reason to suspect anything.
And when did they come back?
About 3/4 of an hour later, and they were very apologetic and said they'd made a mistake. The wardrobe wasn't for Mrs. Lambert after all.
So, you let them back in and they took the wardrobe away?
That's right, but they were only here for a few seconds. I don't see how they could have stolen anything.
I suppose the only really safe thing is not to open the door to anybody. Never go out.
Perhaps I didn't lock the door properly.
No, I'm sure you did, Mrs. Dixon. I think there was a man in the wardrobe.
Balls! Gov, I've checked out that list of names on the Clark case. You know, the wardrobes.
You're a bit late, Mike.
I've just done another one.
Absolutely identical. It's so cocky, it ain't true.
What, even said they were from Bensham's?
Yeah. Get any joy there, did you? It's odds on it's someone in their dispatch department giving names and addresses.
No joy at all. And Bensham's are shut today.
Then why didn't you do it last night? It was on your list.
I couldn't, could I? Chief stopping overtime.
Bloody ridiculous. All right, we'll do it another way. Local inquiries. Someone must have seen those jokers or their van. I can't be lucky twice.
Hello, Henry. Can I speak to Mr. Brownlow, please?
I'm afraid he's busy at the moment, sir. Can I take a message?
Yeah, I want him to authorise some overtime. Henry?
Does it come within the terms?
Yeah. It's for extensive local inquiries into a firm of villains whom we'll lose unless we get a decent lead today.
He'll see you at 2 o'clock, sir.
What? But it's only 12:30 now.
He was going to see you at 2 o'clock in any case, sir. I'm afraid that's the earliest he can manage.
Thank you, Henry.
Shit.
What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Receiving, over.
Go ahead, dude.
Viv, is Taffy around?
Yeah, I think so. Hang on. Tab! What's up? You found the other pig?
No, better than that.
Who's Taffy? Yeah, hello, yeah.
Taffy, what was the name of that bloke who you were supposed to be in court with last week? You know, the firearms charge, the one who didn't show.
Ricky Vassallo. Another wasted morning, that was. Why?
Well... I think I found him.
Ricky? This is supposed to be your daughter's special day, you know.
It'll only be 5 minutes. They're just going to charge you and then we go to the reception.
It's just a formality.
And first they said it was her thyroid, then they said it was her heart. No.
Sorry if this is going to delay your honeymoon a little bit, Ricky.
Nah, we've already had that.
Hey, no, I'm glad we didn't put that on for the reception.
You
can't,
just got your gut full of
quick as you can, please. Oh, you'll be able to see him later on. Just go in there.
Just a minute. God, you think I could paint it a nicer colour?
The last time I was in here was when we got done for that lead. Do you remember?
One bunch of keys, one tie, one packet of confetti, one packet of contraceptives unopened, one watch, gold-coloured, one ring, silver-coloured, one buttonhole.
Agreed?
Yeah. Right. Richard Stephen Vassallo, you are charged that on a warrant granted at Thames Magistrate Court you did fail to appear on the 13th of May 1985. Do you wish to say anything?
Yeah. Can I have a bit of wedding cake?
Oh, for God's sake, someone shove a bit of cake in here, God.
How's the new job, Dennis?
Oh, it's ace. Yeah, 200 quid a week. Cash in hand. Not bad,
eh? What about poor old Connie, then? 3 years she's been waiting to have her legs done. They'll get her right in time to walk her to her coffin.
What's it like?
Oh, you know, clubs, pubs, nothing to do except get...
Right, you lot. Party's over.
Oh, okay, Mr. Cryer.
Yeah, go on, eat the evidence.
Come on, now. I've asked you politely. Push off. Come on now, out of it.
Yeah, but what about my Ricky?
Yeah, well, you'll get him back tomorrow if the magistrate says so.
It's our wedding night tonight.
Yeah, you leave it in the best, man, love.
Look, can't I just say goodbye?
Yeah, all right. Come on now, you lot, hop it! Shut up!
Who is it making all that bleeding row anyway?
Animal life protesters.
Nutters.
They don't believe in shedding blood. You tell them you're a butcher and they'll tear you limb from limb. Gives you that.
Yeah. Well, supposing nobody ate meat, I'd be out of a job for a kick-off, wouldn't I? Anyway, wouldn't be healthy without meat. Good for the old you-know-what and all. 3 pints of Guinness, a couple of pounds of steak and...
I bought you a bit of cake, Ricky.
Oh, I'll sleep on it. Remind me of you.
We miss you at the reception.
Yeah.
Well, bye then.
Bye.
Tell that bleeding Dennis to keep his hands off.
See what you're missing?
Don't you start.
So we've got breaches of the peace in 3, 5 and 6, Ricky Vassallo in 4,
Yeah, that's the illegal immigrant in two.
Oh, really?
Till court tomorrow.
Okay. Well, let's hope we don't get too busy tonight, then. Our prison's always better, then.
Taffy Edwards taking care of it now.
OK, right, run along, then. I'll let my relief know about next month, shall I?
I'm not here.
Chief Soup.
What, now?
That's
all right, tell him I'm on my way up.
Hey, he's on his way up, sir.
Oh, I see we lost a pig.
Shut up, you stupid dykes!
You sure you don't want any food? Well, I'll leave some just in case you change your mind, eh?
Miss Sue Cronin, cell 3. Vegetarian lunch. Compliments of the chef.
Can't eat that.
What's the matter with beans on toast?
I'm a vegan. There's butter on the toast.
Oh, for God's sake, love.
You think it's all a joke, don't you? Meat is murder.
Bloody vegan makes out on a Welsh hill farm.
Come on, it's time
you booked off. Two bloody rats.
I'm not asking for the crown jewels, am I, sir? Just 3 men to do 4 hours apiece, that's all.
I'm sorry, Roy. I don't consider the seriousness of the offence warrants overtime.
But I'm going to lose them, sir. They'll be on another manor in a couple of days.
Well, that's another manor's problem, then, isn't it?
What do you mean, another manor's problems? We're all trying to catch villains, aren't we?
Come in. Hello, what takes you? Copy?
Well, thank you, sir.
Right, gentlemen. Now you're both here. Can I refer you to this memo on operational overtime?
And as opposed to be dealt with every day, and as returners and performers and expenses, and as shotgun licences and pub licences, I mean, people just don't understand.
I think you're beginning to, Reg.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, see it.
I mean, you're fixing up, performing, right?
Yeah, rang just now.
Start on the 3rd, as arranged.
So good that you come down the pub and buy me an over drink.
I'd like to, Jimbo, but I've got to run over and sort out all the bits and pieces. All right.
See ya. Here, he's not moonlighting, is he?
Oh, no, Reg, you just gone to pick up your new truss.
He's all right, he is.
Yeah. Swimming in the urinals now, Edwards?
That's it, Sarge.
Aha, uh-huh, so this is where you hide all morning, might as well.
Leave it out, Sarge.
Bet not, I'll get arrested.
Yeah. See you then.
See you. Oh, might as well. We're going to have to swap the shifts around because of annual leave and long-term sick.
Do what?
Next month, from the 3rd, you'll be on nights instead of late. Oh, after me? Thank you, kind sir.
So, unless it's to investigate a major robbery, a GBH, a rape or a murder, foreseen overtime will not be authorised. But the message from on high is the new cost limits will not reduce police effectiveness. And at Sunhill, I intend to see that that message gets through.
Well, with respect, sir, the message could come down from on high that shit doesn't stink. But that wouldn't make it a fact.
What is a fact, Sergeant, is that we are working to a fixed budget and I expect your cooperation ensuring that we do live within it.
Yes, well, without that cooperation, sir, this place would have ground to a halt weeks ago. It's gone 2 o'clock now. I'm supposed to be on overtime now.
Look, I appreciate all
that,
Bob.
They appreciate that. We get all this bump coming down the line. Is there any bump going up? I mean, do they know how pushed we really are here? Just lately, it's all I can do to put one man out on foot patrol on the entire ground. The entire ground!
We're being asked to do this job with both hands tied behind our backs. I've had 2 inquiries scuppered in the past 24 hours.
Oh, please, Roy, don't give me all that crap.
It is not crap, sir. We've got to face the fact that just because we've reduced our overtime doesn't mean the villains are going to reduce theirs.
But you're being so negative, man. If there's a cheaper, more effective way of doing our job, we should find it. The more we streamline, the more money we save...
What are we, policemen or bloody accountants?
The more money we save, the leaner and fitter the force becomes. The more resources we'll have in the future to give the public the sort of service they want. We have to look to the future, Roy, to be imaginative.
So what you're saying is that we're deliberately not solving crime now in order to solve it in the year 2000?
For a young man, Roy, you can be very obtuse.
No, but that's what you're saying, though, isn't it, sir?
No, it's not what I'm saying
all right,
at all.
Then. Let's take this Mrs. Lambert's case, the wardrobe business. She's not been banged on the head. She's not been raped. The things that have been nicked are all insured. But we don't bother, right?
No.
But you've just stopped me from pursuing inquiries.
It's simply that within the overall equation, certain inquiries are seen to be more cost-effective than others. The new guidelines simply take that into account.
So she goes to the bottom of the pile and she stays there. We're deliberately not solving a crime in order to save a few quid.
We are being realistic, Roy.
Then I think someone ought to tell Mrs. Lambert that and all the other poor souls that think the police are here to help them.
It's simply that the days of carte blanche are over. We're being asked to look at our work and sort out our priorities. To be pragmatic, right?
Pragmatic? What's that supposed to...
Yes, Roy! Right? Roy?
Right, sir.
Thank you. Bob?
Right, sir.
Right, thank you very much, gentlemen.
How many prats in pragmatic, Henry?
What?
Don't bother, I'll look it up myself.
There's nothing wrong with getting a false, but the man's a joke.
And the man's a political animal, Roy. Sways with the wind.
I didn't think animals swayed in the wind.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Cryer. Sorry. Don't drink much. Spill most of it. Let me get you one.
No, I'm driving.
So am I. Tears for souvenirs.
Memories of a love you never met.
Well, overtime doesn't bother me either, anyway. I'd rather be at home than down the Scotch nick any time. Get to see something of your kids, you know.
Have a double Scotch, please, sir.
Oh, yeah. Three girls. 7, 5, and 2.
Sight.
What's this, then? Photos?
Yeah, have a look at that. Eh? Aren't they gorgeous, see?
What's the cost limits on that going to be, eh? 5 grand? 10? What's the price of a life in this new brilliant cost-effective police force, eh?
See, Chummy over there, he's cost-effective. 5,000 quid for policing a picket line. It was all I could do to put one bobby out on the beat at the same time.
Yeah, well, like you say, it's all politics. You want to have a drink?
Say it.
Well,
of course it's bloody politics. What do you mean by
two
politics?
Two Scottishes, please.
What is politics?
Change your vote next time, that's what I mean.
Just holding each other up.
Two Scotches, please,
Sadie. Talking about change your vote to what? How long have I been in this game? 15 years I've been in this game. How many prime ministers have we had in 15 years?
It's cuts everywhere. Teachers, meals on wheels, all right? Just get on with it and have a drink. Sadie!
What's up, love? Lost a quid and found a penny?
Yeah, Sadie. 2 gin and tonics and 3 light and bitters, please. Oh.
Fancy a game of cricket?
Not half.
Come on, me and the kids are going down to Victoria Park this afternoon.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Are you any good?
No. Watch out for yourself.
Roz, you're a stranger in here. What are you having? Sadie, I just thought I'd pop down for a quick pint before I start me decorating.
I'm doing Brownlow's bathroom this afternoon.
Piss off, you silly old cow.
Pint your best, please, love.